Pico here with Corey, the producer of Star Wars The Old Republic. We are checking out patch 1.2. I just played the new Warzone. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. So it takes place on the planet Denova. Novar Coast is the new Warzone in our game update 1.2 Legacy. It's a give you an opportunity to do same be same or Empire versus Republic. It's sort of inspired by the invasion, the storming of the beaches of Normandy. So it's, you know, it's a three-point control domination thing, so you'll be able to, you need to capture two of the points before you can actually start doing damage. It's a lot of fun, you know, it's got some new mechanics in it that aren't in any of our other war zones, so it's, we're excited about it and we're ready to get it out there.
I noticed you added a ranking system. Are there going to be rewards for these rankings?
We will have some ranking rewards. This is our preseason with our ranking system. But yeah, you know, as they rank up higher, you'll be able to get some of the best PvP gear. We have a new level of gear in the game now called War Hero. And then, you know, the highest ranking players will get, you know, statistically the gear will be the same, but it will just have a more prestigious aesthetic to it.
Can you tell us a little bit about the legacy system and what you're adding to that?
Sure. You know, it is game update 1.2 legacy, so it's a big part of the system. You know, we're really excited about it. It's basically going to allow players to start role-playing, building out their own Star Wars families. And aside from that, you know, you get a lot of really cool perks that you can unlock. The first of which will be once you hit level 50 with, say, you played a Chiss agent to level 50, now you're going to have the opportunity to be a Chiss Jedi counselor or a Chiss trooper or a Chiss inquisitor. So that'll be the first unlock. It's a species. And which will also, the species unlocks are purchasable with credits. So you don't have to get to 50 to unlock the new species, but then you'll be able to unlock a lot of other ways that'll allow you to level up your alts to the specific playstyle that you like to do, right? For example, if you love the story content and running flashpoints, you can get buffs for yourself that will, you know, increase your XP for your flashpoints. So it'll allow you to do more of that and with your alts.
You mentioned flashpoints. There's also a new flashpoint. Can you talk a little bit about that one?
Yeah. And it's a massive update. We have a lot of new stuff in it. One of it is the second part of the Rise of the Racq Ghouls story arc. So in game update 1.1, we put out the Siege of Kaon, and this we have the Lost Island, which is part two of that. So you'll actually get to go back to the crazy Dr. Lorik's home base on Ord Mantell and wrap up that story arc.
What else are you adding in patch 1.2?
We have a brand new operation, so Explosive Conflict, which takes place again on Denova, where groups of 8 or 16 can get together and take on some really great bosses and monsters and aliens. And we also did GUI customization this time around. We put in guild banks, the new Warzone ranking, like I mentioned. I mean, it's a big update, and we're really excited about it.
For people who maybe haven't really jumped into Star Wars yet, is there like a really cool fact that would drive them into this?
You know, aside from the fact that it's the largest VO project ever created in entertainment history, you know, so if you're a story nerd or a Star Wars nerd, if it's stuff it appeals to you like me, I'm a huge, you know, story role-playing nerd, love Star Wars. It's just a great way to live out your personal fantasy in the Star Wars universe.
You guys won a world record for that. How did that go? Like, did they approach you?
I believe so. I think that's how that went down, and we did. It's in the Guinness Book of World Records now as the largest VO project.
What's your favorite thing so far about the game altogether and the community and everything?
You know, it's really getting in, playing. You know, I like to do a lot of pugs, just get in and randomly and group with people and play, and it's great. I mean, everybody's really helpful and friendly. It's just a lot less of what I've experienced in other games, you know, in chat and just in the general atmosphere. Like, it's just it's a pretty tight community right now, and I'm really happy with that.
Do you have anything else to let people know about?
You know, really, it's just game update 1.2 is a huge game update, and it's coming in shortly after launch. We've got a lot of great new in-game content in there, so if you're already level 50, please check it out. And if you're not, you know, you have a really strong incentive to get to level 50 now, unlock more things in your legacy, start leveling up your alts, and get more and more cool legacy stuff out of that.
Do you have any plans to add incentives to bring people back to the game? I know it only came out recently, but you know, people play and then they jump off. Do you have any plans in the future for that?
We always have plans. We're always thinking about the future.
So it's just not
nothing there, specific that we're going to talk about today, but okay. We're always planning.
I'm glad you didn't run away like you said you were going
to. I'm almost there. I'm just on the edge of my seat ready to bolt.
Oh, thank you so much for hanging out with us.
Oh, no problem, Pico. It was a pleasure.